Back in 2011, when we had Tropical Storm Lee, people saw this huge chocolate plume of sediment coming all the way down to the Potomac River. It raised an alarm that this must be extremely detrimental to the Chesapeake Bay. We certainly saw a significant impact, especially to the submerged aquatic vegetation right below the dam. But it wasn't the sediment that caused the problem, it was the sheer force, the velocity of the water that ripped up the plants. Sediment actually falls out fairly quickly, but the nutrients associated with the sediments might be more of a problem to the bay and meeting its water quality standards. The Conowingo Dam on the Susquehanna River traps sediments and associated nutrients behind the dam and keeps them from getting into the Chesapeake Bay. Even though the dam's sediment storage capacity has reached what we term dynamic equilibrium, during low flow conditions and normal flow conditions, the dam continues to trap sediments and associated nutrients. It's only during these high flow conditions that cause scouring behind the dam that delivers the sediments and nutrients to the bay in a pulse. In the long term, the bay will be healthier if we pursue management strategies upstream for reducing nitrogen and phosphorus getting into the Susquehanna River. Pursuing short-term strategies like dredging are not as beneficial as taking care of the problem at its source.